I mean, that's utter horseshit.
You melt down the iron, you pour it in molds, usually sand molds, but sometimes ceramic shell. And then you break open the molds once the iron's cooled down, and then you finish it off with different processes to get your final product. During my first iron pour, I was like super discouraged to begin with because there was a lot of guys yelling at each other. And
it's very alpha oriented. It's very
I'm a man, I'm more of a man.
There definitely was that sense of, get out of my way, I got this. You know what I mean? Like there's a lot of that, especially with iron.
Females are like, you know, considered like helpless, dainty, like, oh my God, two women doing metal work. Oh, let me help you.
Yeah, like,
no, don't hurt yourself.
I'm good, yeah, exactly. I think like Alyssa and I both kind of deal with some similar concepts.
Oh, absolutely. Like, identity, sexuality.
Beauty standards of women.
Yeah. Beauty standards and sexuality, I think, and identity, I feel like they're all kind of intertwined in certain ways. Don't you think so?
Absolutely. When I talk to someone at a bar or something, and they're like, oh, what do you do? Like, they're like, and I'm like, oh, like, I'm an artist, I'm a sculptor, like, I do metal casting.
Yep.
Right over their head. They're like.
So anyway, back to your face.
Yeah. Like, it's like, they're not even, like, hearing me talk. Yeah, no. I don't know. That's it.
I find a lot of guys find it intimidating when I tell them I do metal work. They're like, oh God, she's more masculine than me.
Really?
Yeah, they get weird about it.
They get weird. They get quiet, don't they?
Yeah, they have nothing to say about it. They're nothing just like, oh, you're like not really like passive and like girly. What do I do with this?
Yeah.
A lot of my work has to do with the human condition, femininity, certainly. Using fabric and wet drapery, frozen drapery, freezing energy, like that energy of the movement. It's kind of like freezing a moment in time, preserving memory in that way. I think about that a lot. I think about that a lot, especially in relation to my own identity as a woman and just how, you know, women I've known and in my own family often have unrealized dreams for whatever reason, for various reasons.
Personally feel like if I fail to do something to change that statistic, that I'm also letting down women as a whole. That's just me. I just feel like I'm just putting that on myself because I feel like as an artist, it's partially my responsibility to change that statistic. And if I can't do something to help change that, I'm gonna feel like
I failed.
Yeah, like okay. I failed. But not just myself, like all
but like
female
all women.
Artists.
Mm-hmm.
I do think that women face challenges that men don't face. And just like people of color face challenges that white people don't face, yes, we all have the same set of opportunities, but there are always gonna be more challenges for certain people that they have to overcome. So the opportunity is there if you can get past, right? If you can, you're not getting the face value respect, like I said before, right? You have to earn it, right? So, I mean, the number one thing is motherhood. I mean, that's the number one thing, is that, you know, if you are an artist and you want to have a family and you want to have do it all, you know, and I'm a mom too, so I acutely feel this. And those kind of things where you have to take a break, you know, take a break to have your family and come back, that happens in every profession. And that's one of the reasons why women are held back professionally, because they have to abandon their career and then go back and try to pick up the pieces. People tend to say, oh, mom, you get relegated to this like less than category. I don't buy that shit. Because honestly, having my kids was like the most badass thing I ever did. And really was the big, most empowering thing that ever happened in my life. It's a game changer. It's so hard to be a parent and to be a mother that you feel like everything else is cake. really seen that my female students, even when they are reluctant and intimidated, they go for it.
What can we do? I would tell them
to do what they want to do, be independent, don't apologize for being fierce.
And be fearless. Mm-hmm. Be fearless. Be fearless.